Prisoner escort! Halt! Bruce, you're head of world security. I'm going to hold you personally responsible for the President Dennis.
Why? Don't you trust your own security?
Do I have to insist? My name must carry certain powers of the world. Of course it does. Then do as I ask. Right, veteran, come with me. We must make a report to the world authority. They won't believe a word you tell them. I wouldn't be so confident. Right, veteran, come with me. I'll do what I can for you without any trouble. Don't worry. When Mr. James tries to bring this up in court, I won't run away.
You've done very well so far, Federin. It's nothing more than blackmail.
Blackmail? What have I threatened you with?
Nothing.
No, but you would if I refused to.
Why so much doubt in your mind?
There's no need. You can trust me. You can trust me. Trust. Yes, of course. I can trust you. Good fellow. And do not doubt me. I've been here with you for all your life, my dear man. I've done nothing but praise you ever since we first met. I said you'd be world leader. I said I would support you. You found out things about me, lies that would damage me.
And worse than that, you put it all down on paper. Said you'd give it to the press.
Oh, my dear man, this is nothing. This is morally than comprehensive insurance.
What do you want me to do?
Stop worrying. Trust me, I know what I'm doing. Use this.
What is it?
Use it at the right place and the right time. And it will not only decide your future, but the future of Alexander Dennis.
Poison!
I want you to take a message. Clark! What are you doing in this part of the sector?
Leader's orders. Oh, I see. Well, whilst you're here, I have some questions to ask you. I have better things to do, thank you. I want to know what you and Keen Kent were talking about when I saw you last. It's not for me to tell you that. Look, my concern is only for Mr. Thames. Keen Kent is meant to be his sworn enemy. Look, if Mr. Thames wishes to know that, I dare say he'd tell you himself. You'll get no confidences out of me.
Look, how much longer am I going to be kept here? If you choose to be insolent, we're waiting for the security of the car. The volcanic eruptions have disrupted everything.
Mr. President, sir? Ah, Giles. Just the man I wanted to see.
Can't I be escorted to some place more comfortable? I'm simply obeying orders.
Well, maybe we should interpret your orders differently.
Mr. Dennis, what can I do? You're no longer the President. You're a prisoner here.
Giles?
What's the President doing in the corridor?
It's easier to guard him here.
I see.
You all right?
Yes, thank you.
Something to read, perhaps?
That would be a comfort,
yes.
The President is not to be treated as a convicted man before his trial. See, he has whatever he wants.
What can I get for you?
Well, if we have to wait, something to eat and drink, perhaps.
All right. Prison rations captured?
Certainly not. I'll get the best for President Dennis.
From our leader's own kitchens.
And to read?
Well, something light. A book about foreign travels, perhaps.
So, you reckon you know about cooking, eh?
Yes, I used to do lots at home.
All right, then. Give me a menu.
What, now?
Yeah, now.
Soup, fish, meat and pudding, and,
dessert!
That's right, yeah.
You're far too smart for me. Alright then, let's have a recipe.
Now?
Yeah, now!
Oh yes, yes. We used to have a lovely pudding at home, with lots of almonds, eggs, lemon peel, candy peel, oranges, cream, and, oh, it was lovely!
You wouldn't know how to make it.
Oh, it's quite simple, really. You simply whoosh it up all together.
That sounds easy. What's this whoosh up called, then?
Kaiser pudding.
Oh, that's great, yeah. Yeah, I got a job for you, all right. Hear those spuds, yeah, now.
Is that the best you can do for her? The girl must learn.
Bang a stool, are we?
Oh, well, I suppose it could be worse. The place could be overwhelmed with rats. Chewing holes in the gas pipes and setting the ovens on fire and they could burn the whole place down.
It isn't that bad, Brian. Oh, now the chicken's burning. It's brown already. Oh, my lord, it'd be tough as rubber.
Oh, goodness me.
Oh, now the soup's boiling. Did I forget to put salt in it? I can't even remember what I had for breakfast this morning. My mother was right.
Was she?
She wanted me to be an actor. Look, do you want to do something useful?
Oh yes, please. Well, settle down and write down the menus. First course interrupted by a bomb explosion. Second course interrupted by earthquakes. Third course ruined by interference in the kitchen. I'm going out for a walk. It'll probably snow.
It's alright. It isn't that bad once you get to know him. He doesn't like me. It's not just you, he's the same with everyone. Even Mr. Thames. Listen. You must get away from here. Don't get caught up in Mr. Thames' world.
What do you mean?
Seems like you don't like him. Like him?
Well, hello there. Finish writing those menus.
You must be Tom. Hi, I'm Sally. It's good to meet you. Did you hear everything?
Yeah, I heard everything I needed to know.
Kent said I'd find you here. He told me on the walkie-talkie. I was wondering if you can get Fred to talk about Mr. Thames.
Alright, as soon as I can. What have you been doing?
I managed to slip outside until Astrid was happened.
Well, you might have told me, Tom. There was no time to try to get Denish away.
And take him to the doctor.
He'd believe Denish.
Yes, he would.
But how can she get in? Thames has guards everywhere. But she's got friends here. They're going to whoosh her up with some sort of uniform. Or what sort of uniform? I don't know, mesh delivery or something. Shh, wait.
Yes. Yes, you're quite right. Yes, I don't know whether to make up my mind if Federin would be to consider the new controller or not.
Alright, they've gone. Astrid and Keen Ken were absolutely right. Mr. Thames is an evil man. I can somehow sense it from all the people here.
Yeah, he's bad, alright. He's had Denish arrested and he's got this man, Federin, even out of his hand.
Why should he do that? Or remove an honest man and put a weaker man in his place. That way, in some sort of a hold on him.
That way, Mr. Thames can take over the territory.
I see. And everything's turmoil because of the earthquakes, and that's just the most dangerous, to say the least.
But... you don't really believe Mr. Thames can cause earthquakes, do you?
I'm pretty sure Mr. Thames is causing the earthquakes, Doctor, just as I'm sure as Tally and Tom can just tell you how bad he really is.
Why make earthquakes?
A few years ago, Doctor, when one country wanted to invade another, it said something about attacking the confidence of that country, throwing it into confusion, making it ripe for takeover. That's exactly what's happening here, only a different way.
So what you're saying is the master, I mean, Mr. Thames, has found a way of harnessing the natural forces of the Earth. Sounds very difficult to explain, but not impossible, I mind you.
So, you say it's coming from the research station, Mr. Thames' research station, eh?
That's what I believe, in spite of...
Well, despite a number of reasons. He invented the Sun Store, a brilliant event. He managed to find a way of shooting energy out to places where he stopped Sun.
What made you suspicious?
The money he was spending in the research station. The materials he was using in the food pocket didn't make sense. I had all the papers, the requisition orders.
Well, that's valuable evidence.
All destroyed and new ones came in, and I was made out to be the criminal. Oh, by suggestion, of course. Any accusation I made against Mr. Thames, I was only used to throw suspicion on myself. A sort of, Jekyll and Hyde character, perhaps, Mr. Thames. It'll be interesting to see what report Tom brings back.
Security, quick! Hyde!
Quick, get in here.
I hope there's plenty of air in here.
Yes, there's plenty. Just be quiet.
So, it's you. What are you doing here?
You're on research station territory. Not quite. Have a look at the boundary lines.
That's very clever.
Well, what are you doing here? I don't have to answer your questions.
Bird watching, no doubt.
Perhaps.
Well, well, well. A momentum of the old days.
You're in the right to...
It's just an accident. Now you won't be staying in this facility, will you?
You can't make me leave here!
Hey, what are you doing?
All right. That's enough.
Well, there's not much point in you staying here now, is there?
Oh, and I wouldn't complain to anyone about this, though, you can't. After all, no one will believe you. Will they?
Well, it's very stuffy in there. Oh, now do you believe the bunch of amateurs that we're up against? Unfriendly, destructive, but not necessarily evil. Well, why won't you believe me? It's too important. I must be sure.
Let's look at this. Oh, sad, really, isn't it? People spend all their time making nice things. Other people come along and break them.
That's what I'm trying to tell you about Mr. Thames. He's trying to destroy the world!
Facts.
Kent. I must have facts. That's what I hope Tom's going to bring back.